In today's video, I have an exciting ready-to-wear reveal for you. This is an item I saw on the runway, contacted my SA, then to realize the price is so ridiculous and more expensive than most mini bags at that time that I couldn't justify the purchase. And I erased it from my mind because the price was so ridiculous. But I found it for 45% off the retail price. So it was a no-brainer for me to add to cart and check out. So we're going to start with a reveal, give you reasons for why I love it, and there'll be mod shots at the end. So before we get started, remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment. So here she is. She's from the 2020 A collection, the Métier des Arts. Probably didn't pronounce that correctly. And she's straight from the runway. When I first saw the entire 2020 collection on the runway, this piece captured my heart. As you get to know me, I do love really well-done graphic clothing. I thought the beading was pretty genius. If you look up close, you can see all the beading. These are beads, and then these flower petals are actually leather pieces that's been cut out. If you look up close, you can see the ruthenium colored beads. And what I mean by that is, it's not like a bright silver, and it's not black, but it's somewhere in between, but it's very sophisticated. And looking closely at the flowers, they're actually made out of leather. Some of the leather pieces are a little bit more shiny and others are not. And that's why it gives you a slight shimmer. If the whole thing was just shiny leather or non-shiny leather, it wouldn't have the same effect. And down here, the lettering is actually sequin. I find the craftsmanship beautiful. When the 2020 A collection finally hit the stores, I reached out to my SA. And I found out the price tag was $4,600. There was no way for me to justify that purchase. And back in 2020, at that time, a mini rectangle bag was $3,800. So this sweatshirt would have been $1,000 more than the mini bag. And the mini bag is actually made out of leather and chains. This is made out of cotton, a little bit of leather, some beading, and some sequin. I started to add luxury ready-to-wear pieces about 2 years ago. And I usually add 1 to 2 pieces a year. And I'm very picky about what I decide to add to my collection because ready-to-wear doesn't have great resale value, unlike some bags. And of course, because you're wearing it, there is wear and tear. So when I do add ready-to-wear, I prefer darker colors, just like this piece. This is also Chanel, which I got during the sale. And as you can see, this is a lighter piece. And it will show wear and tear a lot faster. And the other concern about the sweatshirt is, because it has leather pieces, you can't just throw it in the wash. This has to be taken to a professional cleaner who knows how to handle undetachable leather pieces. So despite all those reasons, this is my favorite ready-to-wear piece. So what I'm trying to say here is, if you love the item, you love the item. No matter all the flaws or all the deal breakers that I thought I had. And the other thing to consider is, I do have one Chanel jacket, but for me personally, I get more wear out of knitwear like this and sweatshirts like this. And with Chanel, although this is a sweatshirt, this is the most elevated sweatshirt I've seen them make, period. And I looked at a lot of vintage stuff. And so far, if I could only pick one sweatshirt from all of Chanel ready-to-wear, she would be it. So that's why I think for me, this is gonna be a good buy. All right, so let's talk about the price. So the retail price for this was $4,600. And even at that price, this sweatshirt was sold out. Even if I wanted to buy this at the Chanel sale, it was unlikely that this would still be around a year later for the sale. So when I saw it on a pre-love site for 45% off, which knocked the price down to $2,500, which is still a lot, don't get me wrong, it's still a lot. I wanted to order her, have her at my house, and try it on with all my clothing to see if she'll work with the rest of my closet family. And she definitely did. Up next, let's do some mod shots. So I prefer oversized sweatshirts and knits. So I actually got this in the large. So this is a very common everyday look. I'm just wearing pants with a sweatshirt. But I can dress it up slightly with a lambskin clutch. And because there's leather and beading all throughout, it totally elevates the everyday look. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.